And breaking news regarding the 10 freeway, the repairs set to be done far ahead of schedule. The new timetable for commuters just announced moments ago. Good evening, I'm Micah Ullman.
And I'm Cher Calvin. We begin this hour with breaking news. Crews working on the shuttered stretch of the 10 freeway in downtown LA, shattering expectations as the governor announces some lanes will reopen as early as next week.
Carlos Saucedo live in downtown Los Angeles.
Governor and the mayor, they are en route. They were supposed to give a progress update at 4:45 this afternoon. They are running late. We're told they are stuck in traffic. The mayor encouraging Angelenos to take public transit.
As traffic congestion continues to snarl in the downtown area, officials say they're making progress on emergency cleanup and repairs on the 10 freeway. Crews have removed enough debris to fill four Olympic-sized swimming pools. That includes more than two dozen burned-out vehicles. And while they're still on track to reopen the freeway within 3 to 5 weeks, it could not come soon enough.
Now, despite efforts that we have made over the last few days to manage traffic, we have noticed bottlenecks at key intersections.
Like on Alameda near Olympic. To help ease congestion, the city is adding more white-glove traffic officers and created an additional turn lane in each direction. The mayor pleading to the public to stay off surface streets and take public transportation.
Caltrans certainly supports the elements of this motion to work with Metro.
At this morning's Metro meeting, Mayor Bass introduced a motion to promote ridership and expand service during this state of emergency. The downtown commuter express buses and dash service are free for riders. And while the arson investigation continues into who started the fire, new questions are emerging about how long Caltrans was aware of the hazardous conditions underneath its freeways. KTLA confirming Caltrans was on site on October 6 inspecting the area weeks before the fire. And this months earlier, a similar pallet fire from April of 2022 also forced the temporary closure of the 10 freeway near the Lawrence Street off-ramp. KTLA has learned that the fire was also on nearby Caltrans right-of-way property. The storage area leased to a produce company. Violation letters were sent to the tenant to address deficiencies with multiple follow-up inspections. The fire caused by a homeless encampment.
So far, no word on a suspect with the fire behind me here. Again, the governor and the mayor, they are en route, expected to give a progress update on the repairs being done here. We'll bring you that live. We're live in downtown LA. Carlos Salcedo, KTLA 5 News.
Carlos, thank you.